To transfer complete projects or libraries from one SimaPro user to another requires two sets of actions. First, exporting the project and then importing it. This is done using the Export SimaPro Database and Import SimaPro Database functions. Exchanging databases provides the most complete and consistent way to exchange data in SimaPro. In this video, we will show you how you can export and then import a project and highlight some important points you have to keep in mind during the process. Before beginning the export procedure, clearly communicate with the recipient to determine three things. First, what information you need to export. Limiting the amount of data that you need to export saves you a lot of time. Second, which version of the SimaPro software they are using. For example, if you are using SimaPro 7.3, a user with an older version of SimaPro would not be able to open your project. Finally, check whether or not you are using the same databases. If you are using different versions of methods or libraries, the recipient risks downgrading or upgrading their data, or even getting different results with the same project. So how can you check which version of the methods or libraries you are using? Well, for methods, you can see the version number of the method in the methods section. As for libraries, go to File, Open Project, select the library you want to check, and then you can see the version date or number in the comment field. Now let's move on to the export procedure, and let's assume you want to export the project Introduction to SimaPro 7, which is located in the Professional database. While in the Professional database, go to File, Export SimaPro Database. Any open project or library will be closed, and a window will pop up that offers a number of export options. You first have to define which directory or drive you want to export the database to, and what this exported database will be called. Click Browse to select any of the locations you had previously used from the drop-down menu. If you want to export to another location, click Browse again and choose or create a new folder. Type in a name for the database and click Save. In the Projects tab, you can select which projects and libraries you would like to export. In this case, I will only select the project Introduction to SimaPro 7. As a project normally uses data from libraries, all libraries used in the project Introduction to SimaPro 7 will be automatically exported, even if you did not explicitly select them at this point. This means, however, that all data in these libraries will be exported. If you prefer not to export entire libraries, but only data that you have used in your project, select the option Only include library items in selected projects. This can greatly reduce the size of the export and save you considerable time in the process. Under the General Objects tab, you can specify which general data, such as substances, units, quantities, etc., should be exported. You can choose to export all available objects or only those that are actually used in the projects you want to export. Next, click Export. The database will be scanned and you will get a summary of all data that will be exported to the new database. Click OK to start the export. Once export is completed, you will have 77 numbered files ending with NX1. These will be saved in the directory you had chosen earlier. Due to their large size, you can zip these files to share with others. If you want to import a SimaPro database in your own database, you should realize that importing not only means that new data is added to your database, but very often existing data in your libraries or projects is overwritten. So before we explain how to actually import a database, let's point out which data may be overwritten and under which circumstances. This includes processes, product stages, methods, and substance names. Process data in libraries will be replaced only if the project name is identical and the process identifier matches. Product stages will be overwritten after confirmation if they have an identical name. This can be avoided by renaming your current product stages. As for methods, they will be overwritten after confirmation if they have an identical name. This can be avoided by renaming your current methods. And for substances, if the substance names are identical, the imported substance will overwrite your existing substance along with a cast number and common field. Now let's start the import procedure, where I would like to import the project Introduction to SimaPro 7 into my professional database. While in the professional database, go to File, Import SimaPro Database, and browse to the database you want to import. In this case, Database 1. In the Projects tab, you can select which projects and libraries you would like to import. At the bottom of the tab, you are presented with two additional options. Only include library items used in selected projects. Select this option to only import library data that is actually used in selected projects. This way, you can avoid importing entire libraries, thus saving you a lot of time and reducing the risk of overwriting data. Delete empty process categories. Select this option only if you have changed the structure and need to remove all empty categories or subcategories throughout your database. Under the General Objects tab, you can specify which general data, such as substances, units, quantities, etc., should be imported. You can choose to import all available objects or only those that are actually used in the projects you want to import, as we did previously with library items. Next, click Import. The database will be scanned and you will get an overview of all data that will be added or replaced. It is recommended to store this overview as a confirmation of all changes that will be made to your current database. Click OK to start the import process. You will be asked to verify the replacement of each process. Keeping in mind the precautions we outlined at the beginning of the section, click Yes to All to accept all replacements. After a final confirmation, you will be prompted to back up your current database. This is a compulsory step. If the backup is cancelled, the import will also be cancelled. Click OK and choose a location to save your backup. Once the backup database has been created, the actual import starts. This step can be quite time-consuming. A confirmation message will appear once the import is completed successfully. If you now go to File, Open Project, the project you just imported will be on the list.